One of the challenges we're facing today is that a great number of children are growing up in high-risk communities, schools, families, and so forth. What we're trying to do is to bring the best of science and practice to help all those who work with children in whatever kind of role to enable children to develop their strengths, to be resilient, and to thrive. And to do that, we actually focus on four universal growth needs that all children have. One way of describing that list of four is to use the brain-based labels of attachment, achievement, autonomy, and altruism. If you would convert that into the value words that are used in the Circle of Courage, it would be belonging, mastery, independence, and generosity. If we can rear children in environments where they belong, where they can master and develop their talents, where they can learn to be responsibly self-controlled, and where they can contribute to others, then they're healthy. And so often what we have are kids that have difficulty, have not had their needs met in that. And then they show that in ways that are kind of disruptive at times. Some of them retreat, from adults. Some of them give up in school or life. Some of them actually fight against, teachers and caregivers. And what tends to happen is that if adults don't have the right kind of training, they get sucked into conflict cycles with these kids, and they react to the problems instead of respond to the needs. And all of the research on the brain ties in with another exciting area of research, which we call resilience science. And resilience is the study of how human beings survive hardship, cope with adversity. And the conventional wisdom used to be that if bad things happen, your life is going to be a mess forever. What we now can see is that humans are really designed to find new ways of coping, of thriving. And it gets back to these four concepts that we talked about before. Let's say a kid comes from a difficult family background. If we can restore those family bonds or find other kinds of supportive adult and peer relationships, young people thrive. Mastery. If a young person can find some talents, some skills, for example, achievement in school, puts them on a positive trajectory, even if you have other problems. Independence. By that, I really mean the ability to manage your own emotions and take charge of your life. Think of, for example, of a youth who's easily misled by peers who say, oh, let's go out and get in trouble here. So successful young people learn to set their own course, make their own decision. For example, research shows that children at 3 years of age who show compassion are more likely to succeed academically at eighth grade. And in fact, caring behavior at third grade is a better predictor of academic success at eighth grade than academic achievement. What happens is you've got children now bonded to school, to adults, to helping one another, and they naturally learn and thrive. So whether I'm talking to teachers, foster parents, parents, other caregivers, you get back to the same universal growth needs that all children have in every culture. How can they connect with caring adults and peers? How can they develop their talents? How do they learn to be responsible? And then how do they contribute? How do we get young people helping one another? So many of the things that we do really are not founded by research, like this tremendous push to spend more time on academics so you can raise test scores, when in reality, if you meet the growth needs of kids, they will naturally thrive